beekeeper here. Glad to be here. Good to be here. Dream number 37. That's something I'm just sort of looking at and looking at some of these numbers and just it's a thing. Yeah, Timothy agrees. It's a thing. It's a thing. Ah. I have two people online. I'd like to give a nod of recognition to Willamus23 for the follow. Your follow put me at 25 just in time for the stream, so I have reached that halfway point to that magical number of 50 at which Twitch ceases to regard me as a parasite and starts to see me as a potentially exploitable resource. I have such mixed feelings. We are, as the title card says, post day 100. Now what? This is only the third time that I have played The Wandering Village, and the first two times I did not get this far. The first time I realized I'd made some very bad decisions about my village layout, and there just was no recovering. The second time I got a lot better as far as efficiency, but ran into some allocation issues and finally had a poison forest coming up that I just was not ready for. And took a third try at it, which is the one that we're following now. So, well. And here we are. I mean, we're at day 100. My plan at this point is simply to see where this particular session goes. I will play it through until I run into something that just ends my run. Sooner or later, it's going to happen. It seems somewhat inevitable. Although there is an achievement for getting up to 500 people in residence, and I just can't even imagine that. That seems like a shocking. Hello, hello, The Wandering Village. You're not familiar. Willamist, welcome, welcome. So glad to see you. Were you on a minute ago when I gave you a shout out? If not, let me do that again. Because you following put me at 25 followers halfway to the magic 50 just in time for this stream, and I really appreciate that. The Wandering Village is a post-apocalyptic farm sim in which you develop a symbiotic relationship with a kaiju. It has a couple of very important lessons to teach. The biggest of them being that if you do not move from being a parasite upon the land to being in symbiosis with it, neither you nor the land will survive. This is a very stark and harsh lesson. Day 100 brought us to the decaying remains of another kaiju that had not been as fortunate as ours and our village. We have, well, let's just get to it. It'll become obvious as we go. Let's just launch into this. Yes, we know about researchers. So here is our village. And we're getting a message here to disable the village doctor, which is the absolute worst advice. This is something the game designers should be just totally ashamed of. Let us go from the village out a little ways so that you see where we are. We are on the back of Anbu. Anbu is currently sleeping. We're going to let Anbu sleep, and we're going to zoom out to here, and our scavenging party is out here. They are scavenging, I believe, at a poison forest, which is going to give them some grief. Let us come back to here, and... yeah, they have come back. Oh! After a long walk, the party passes a muddy spot in the desert. A brave scavenger wants to get a better look and inspects it. Seconds later, they are knee-deep in quicksand. We have three options. There's no time to lose. We have to help fast. It's too dangerous to go in. Send the rest of the party to look for something to pull their friend out. Or... the situation is too dangerous. There's nothing we can do. I am not abandoning. Discworld, kind of, sort of, on a micro scale. I am not abandoning a scavenger. Absolutely not. But a rash, rushing in this game is a bad idea. Taking the cautious approach is normally the best option. So I'm going to... let's look for something to pull this person out. Commit. They manage to find a rope just in time. After pulling their friend out, they discover a source of fresh water underneath the sand. They come back with 40 water and 20 sand. That's a tremendous amount of stuff. Hooray! That is terrific. Yes, we will accept this. Oh. Splendid results. Let us... have we been here? Let's get him off to this shrine. So here is Anbu. And this is the biome that we are currently traveling through. The disc is simply the range of our vision. That is the farthest that we can see from atop Anbu. We are approaching a crossroads, at which point we will have a chance to try to influence Anbu as to which direction to go. Green is not necessarily good. It can mean a much higher density of poison, like this poison forest here. So, let us get back to here for a second. Our scavengers are currently out. And let's see, how are we doing? We have a number of people idle. I'm not going to worry about idols. I'm not worried about idols. We're going to have some. One of them is the village doctor. And we are not, under any circumstances, going to decommission the village doctor just because there's no patients currently. I want that person standing around on call between the disc representation and the civilization on the back of a giant creature. It just sprang to my mind. It is an obvious association. Scavenging came back with one knowledge. That knowledge will get spent at one of our research buildings to advance things. We will send them to a dune to get sand. We will need that at the glassmaker at some point. Let's see, we are in an arid and hot biome right now. The good news being that the ground toxicity is none. This is a post-apocalyptic game. The apocalypse was toxic in nature. We're not sure completely, but we keep track of Anbu's poison level. Currently 20. When it goes above 20, we can do something about it. Hunger, we can help with that. Sleepiness, Nothing for that but rest, but and we are okay. Cool. We got 28 sand. We're going to hit that dune. Sin party. Zippity pop. I'm going through a lot really fast, I understand. Let me just do a few things here. What I'm doing is marking these trees for harvest. The yellow one is a mother tree, which spawns new trees around it. So I only want to cut a mother tree if I really want to get rid of a source of more trees. I have an area effect harvest marker, but I want to be cautious with that because I'm working around Anbu's spines. And Anbu's spines can be harvested for stone, but it upsets Anbu pretty badly. Kind of like having your toenails clipped too close. It stings. Does not like it, and I cannot say as I blame Anbu for this. Our research right now... Oh, we're not doing anything? Why aren't we doing any research? Build a research tree. Anbu. We're supposed to be working on Pet Anbu. Why aren't we working on Pet Anbu? There we go. Ah, good grief. Up here we have our supplies. We're actually doing reasonably well on food. We've got two farms. One here. Fields, one here, fields. Let's zoom in on this because this gets all sorts of interesting. The artwork on this gets all sorts of intriguing. And here we've got a bunch of carriers picking up corn from the farm and taking it to a kitchen where it'll get turned into polenta. Oh, this one's making berry muesli, sorry. That's a windmill, obviously. It's making flour, which then goes off to a bakery to be made into bread. Let's see. Let's back very carefully here. That's making beet soup. That one over there. That one. That one's making polenta. There's where the corn is going. Ooh. These are pantries, so raw ingredients and finished product both get stored here. Ideally, we want to keep a nice supply of food in the pantry. We don't quite have enough people going here, and that's something I should set. Let me back out a ways. And see, we are looking for a person at the village doctor. We really ought to have another person there. I want to start thinking about some of these kitchens. This one needs another person. This one needs another person. And they're advertising for people, but there aren't any people available right now. We got a decision here. Dancing under the hot sun. Looking for protection from the sun, your scavengers walk under a cliff formation. There you meet a tribe performing a dance ritual. Ask them for shelter and offer them some water. I have enough water to be able to do that. Oh, a dance party. Let's join. That sounds like something that a colonizer would do. That just sounds like, you know, no, we don't want to just walk. They're performing a ritual here. It's better not to interfere in the ritual. Let's look for resources elsewhere. We can just abandon this and walk away. When meeting people, other people in this game, it is best to reach out. offering them resources is a good way to win trust, we may end up with one of them joining as a board Anbu. I'm going to ask them for shelter and offer them water in compensation for it. This is just what they were praying for. In return, they offer you some food. So we spent 40 water and we got 46 corn. Nice. Except. There we go. Another thing this game teaches is that cooperation is a good thing. Reach out. Let's go send a party to that forest. That's a very distant one, and I want to hit it before it goes out of reach. If we go south here, we could still hit it. If we go west, then, you know, we're not going to be able to. And Anbu may or may not listen when we offer a suggestion at the crossroads. One of the factors is trust. We have to build enough trust with Anbu that when we see a hazard or an opportunity and give Anbu advice, we hope Anbu will accept it. Just go look at Anbu. Anbu is still snoozy. Since we are in a safe area, we want to let Anbu just sleep this out. We can, in an emergency, blow a really big horn and give Anbu a walk command and get Anbu woke up and moving. Assuming that Anbu's sleepiness is low enough, there is a point where Anbu will ignore all commands and will lie down and sleep. If we are in an ocean biome, this is lethal. So yeah, we have a lie down command and a sleep command, and we can suggest to Anbu that, hey, now would be a real good time to take a nap before we have to swim across this water. Now, you will not see the ocean biome in this particular session. It is in a forthcoming release. I am allowed to talk about it, but I cannot show you any images or footage from it. The developers have asked people who have access to the roadmap to wait for them to show it off first. And yeah, that's fair. They built it. They get to show it off first. Animal doctor. We do have a couple options here. We can fire off an antidote. Anbu's poison level is not quite enough to need it. And then we also have the ability to cure injury. Both of which will increase trust. We have the ability to feed Anbu. We can pop a whacking huge Scooby snack in... Well, let me just... I'm sorry, I gotta bring this up. Yes, that is in fact a trebuchet. Just mark these trees for priority removal here. That is, in fact, a trebuchet, and what we do is we take a whacking huge Scooby snack and load it in the trebuchet and fire off a signal so that Anbu knows that there is an incoming cookie and let fly with it. And Anbu snaps it out of the air. Greetings, greetings. Okay, hey, we got somebody else showing up. Let's see, we got Square 12 Blep. Okay, identifying emoji not processed. Whoops. Anbu has awakened. and is getting into motion. Anbu is a rare and special creature. Alice, greetings. How you doing? We are in unknown territory at this point. I have not played this game past day 100 before. So we are just moving right along here. Got a bunch of stuff going on. Got, we were just looking at the trebuchet there. That is our scout tower, which is not built yet. Let's see. I missed a couple here. Let's pop those trees so that we have clear there. That's continuing to populate. That's getting a little bit on the dense side over here. And it's going to start. I need to get rid of the. I hate to do this, but I have to get rid of that mother tree. It's crowding my berry gatherer to the point I can't even see my berry gatherer under there. Demon dog. Greetings, welcome, welcome. Oop, 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 nope, 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 nope. I don't want to mess with the berry gatherer. I'm just trying to tag. There we go. Alright, let's zoom out. And out. What do we got? Oh, look at that. A sleepy spot. Pity Anbu isn't sleepy. Just woke up from a very long nap. So, sleepy spot not so useful. Waiting decision. Giant tree. After walking through the magical looking woods, hint, plop, thud, they arrive at a clearing. A magnificent tree is standing in its center. Let's grab our axes. There's plenty of quality wood waiting for us. This is the hasty decision. It is bad. This tree must be a special one. It is better to cut the trees around it. This is the cautious decision. This tree has a magical feel to it. We'd better leave. We can just walk away. It's... Grabbing your axes is mean to the tree. Indeed, it is. We have recognized that this is, in fact, a special tree. We need wood. We are going to cut the trees around it and go with the cautious approach. This is normally the correct decision in this game. An uneasy feeling creeps over your scavengers while cutting down the trees. We did not do the right thing. But they carry on, fill up the reserves, and leave. We got 32 wood, but I don't feel good about it. Let's go to the quarry. Something... Yeah, uh-oh. You are not getting told that anybody got poisoned or anything, so we're good there. I'm really concerned here. Let us... Back to here. Alright, so we have green area here. Going that way, we're going into cold biome. So it's going to be temperate. Temperate, however, you can already see poison here. Nice temperatures bring a higher likelihood of poison. Now it's just piss. Let's see. Should have taken down the vampire tree that was feeding off the life force of those around them. Those are the worst. Eloquent in concept, wooden in execution, but now it's just pissed off. Yeah, well. We're moving on. The fact that we have pissed off the tree is going to be irrelevant pretty soon. Our big issue is that Anbu is getting hungry. Anbu is at 34%. We're going to need to think about this in the near future. We do have a reasonable supply of Anbu Chow. We are at day 105. Let us bop to here and zoom out a little bit here. Zap down to the far end. Oh my goodness, I have not been paying attention here. Okay, bring up the area select tool, and I don't see any spines here. Okay, cup hop. And a pop. There's a spine there. I gotta be real careful. And what's that? I don't know. Anbu seems unsure about which path to take at the upcoming crossroads. Anbu is seeking our advice. We need to think about this. We can go the green way and risk increased poison, or go the cold way and have, you know, issues with crops. I'm going to go for southeast. Anbu accepts your command. We're going to go the green way. You have chosen the path. I'll be back. Gonna relocate. Which means we need to go in and hit this shrine, because it's a dune right in the path. Interesting. Oh, bugger. That's scorching sand. We're going to have to... I made a bad decision. God darn it. I haven't seen that before. Alright, so we have a run command. We need to go and feed Anbu. Let's get our scavenging party off, and then we are going to go to the Anbu level, and we need to feed Anbu. Preparing. There is now work being done at the trebuchet. We'll watch what happens at the trebuchet later. I want to... This is just a thing. Flying biscuit. Anbu's hunger will now retreat, and Anbu will give us a bit more trust, which is a good thing because we are about to call upon that trust. As soon as we hit that red zone, we gotta hit the horn blower and say run. Oh, some good news. That's Anbu food. Yep, Anbu feeding spot. So. Here we go. That Anbu has been researched. Absolutely. Let's go for the cottage and commit. Ignore the blood extractor. That upsets Anbu. Upset me. Okie dokie. Let's see. We got September. Yes, I got it. I was trying to get that from the emoji this time before I got to the end of the line. Alrighty. We got, good stuff happening here. Mark a bunch of that. We need to bounce over to here. See how close we are to the impingement here. I don't want to give Anbu the order until I have to, but it's about to go. Day 106. I'm waiting for the environmental warning. We decided that it's actually not heartbreaking to just sign when we say hi to you. Accessibility is a two-way street. Thank you, Wing Princess. Okay, there it is. Run. Anbu accepts your command. A scavenging party returned. They brought back one knowledge. Yeah, here we're hitting the scorching sand. We have told Anbu, all it. Anbu is... sleepiness is going to go up fast here. We're fatiguing Anbu. And we also just fed Anbu, which is good because hunger is likely to be rising as well. Haven't done this before. We are just about at a limit here, I think. Come on, come on. We can get out of this mess. Still seeing the special effects here. Anbu's gonna wear out. Waiting for the scorching sand to go out. Walk. Anbu accepts your command. Whew, okay. Didn't see any major ill effects here. Anbu wags its tail. I like how Anbu is creeching constantly. Oh yeah, Anbu is the star of this game. There is no question about it. Those are nomads. They were moving this way. They're moving left and right. We might have hit them if we went up there. We're not going to hit them down here. Which is a shame because we could use some new people. Definitely use some new people. There we go. Ground toxicity is high, and Anbu is tired. See, this is a this is where we're gonna run into problems. And then what's this? Oh, Jesus, spore cloud. Yeah, remember when I said that green had an increased instance of poison? Kirby is the star of the show. Oh yeah, Anbu is a lot like Kirby in that way. Yeah, absolutely. Anbu is very much the star of the show. Well, we have fresh food. We don't have a place for Anbu to sleep, which is a serious problem because Anbu's tired. Crossing the sand wore Anbu out a bit, and we're going to deal with that. Going up awfully fast. A scavenging party came back with 21 bread. Yay. Let's send them to the forest near the, that's near the nomads. Maybe something will happen. Maybe we'll get lucky. That spore cloud has got me really worried. Oh, I made a bad decision here. I really should have sent us the other direction. This is not good. Not good. Don't like it. Gonna be a problem. Gonna be a big thumping problem. Let us... get the harvest tool and these things for harvest. Excuse me. Day 107. Love the music on this. Look at the backgrounds here. We're going through this green area and it's obviously a toxic zone. This is what happened to the world. Allow me to introducing myself. Hello. Anbu gets much more tired. Anbu is going to lie down and sleep whether we have any say in it or not. We have... poisoned nomads. I am hoping that they just stay still. We can pick them up. We can. We have a doctor. We have medication. Anbu is only 25% hungry, but is sick at 68% tired. At 77%, Anbu is going to lie down. Just quoting Boris Badenov. Ah. Allow me to introducing myself. Hello. And do the accent. Health is 91% right now. So we're not in need of administering medication, but brought back wood. Okay, let's send him to the quarry. That's a short distance. That spore cloud is... I just can't tell... I'm not even sure which direction it's going. And we're walking into an area here. Okay, Anbu has decided that Anbu has the munchies. All gone. Anbu has no hunger, but is at 73%. We are about to have to deal with Anbu being poisoned, with our villagers being poisoned. It's going to get very, very messy. Let's go and clear this poison forest as far as scavenging goes. Good news being, these nomads are not moving. There's no dotted line. They're not moving back and forth. These theoretically were, but... or are? Not really sure. Alright, let's see. Our doctor has 15 out of 15 herb in stock. We have the herbalist right next door with 12 herb in stock. And the herbalist out here planting and harvesting herb. We're not optimized. We need to change to beets, and we need to change to wheat. Here we go. We've been in this biome for a couple of days, and I completely missed that, and I'm very sorry. Good news here, our water supply is filling starting to fill back up. The air wells are... Since it is humid, the air wells are functioning nicely. Evaporators, or whatever you want to call them. Anbu is critical here. Anbu has yawned. Our scavenging party got poisoned. That's going to take a minute or two. Yeah. Anbu is going to be more poisoned in a minute, and we are going to have to take care of that. The good news is we can take care of that. We have a big stockpile of herb, and it takes 10 herb per shot. We got 40 herbs. We got 4 shots to, and that each one will cure 20%. So we could, we'll be able to take care of Anbu. Anbu's health is at 91%, so we're nowhere near even needing. I'm going to hold off on the pet Anbu for right now. Don't want to pet Anbu while Anbu is... Anbu has wagged its tail again. Anbu is... At least we're getting some signals here that Anbu is at least in a hopeful mood. ...84%. We are here. Going to go on and fire off an expedition there. And we've got that coming up. That desert is looking better and better. Uh-oh. We now have high toxicity. We are going to start getting poison cases. Our doctor is going to be darned busy. Good news being, we can even... we do have a doctor. Anbu isn't cozy at all. Moving to pantry. Alright, well, if the doctor is going to the pantry, then the doctor has time to go to the pantry and doesn't have anybody that they urgently need to go see. Moving to dirt road. Okay, let's just hope. What I want to do is let Anbu sleep for a short time. I'm going to take it down to like 60%, and then I'm going to hit a walk command and wake Anbu up. We need to get moving. We cannot stay here. It is not safe. Oh no. The spore cloud. Why did I know this was going to happen? Here it comes. Giant tree. Ooh, this tree has a magical feel to it. We'd better leave. On the way back, your scavengers feel a strong wind blowing out of the woods, making a sound that reminds them of an old language. A small gift awaits them back at the entrance. 30 wood planks. There we go. Respect the tree. Okay. That bloody spore cloud. Is it moving away? Is it... What the hell is it doing? I don't even know. It's got me very worried. Come on, Anbu. 75%. Sleep faster. Oh, this has me worried. We do have a decontaminator. We have 3 people working for it. They have plenty of biogas. They're fully loaded. And for their flamethrowers. So as soon we got somebody poisoned there. Small toxic cloud full of dangerous spores temporarily increases toxicity levels and spawns poisonous plants on Anbu's back. We've been hit with the spore cloud. Here's the spore cloud. Watching for poisonous plants. Toxicity level very high. Anbu, 67. Uh-oh. Is that... We've got decontaminators. Should be keeping an eye on things here. Poison plant. Get rid of it. On the hall. Alright, we gotta wake up Anbu and get out of here. We're in deep, deep trouble. All of us. We gotta get out of here. Anbu, I am sorry. I would have let you sleep longer if I could. Okay, here is a decontaminator with a flamethrower on their way around. Let's just follow them a minute. See what we see. Trying to keep a watch for poisonous plants spawning. They're still in the cloud. It's all by the music. We got a number of poison cases. The doctor's going to be very busy. And we need to treat Anbu for poison. That's Anbu food and more poison. That's a desert. We can feed Anbu. The music is fading. The music has faded. The danger, the immediate threat has passed, but we have to check for any poison plants that got in. Sometimes they spawn faster than the decontaminators can go burn them. Giant tree, we've seen that one before. We're buggering off. Commit. Okay. Let us, we have that coming up in just a few seconds here. Let us send our party there. And before we get there, let us go on and antidote. We are going to reduce Anbu's poison level. Now this gets fun. Look, the Anbu doctor actually flies a hot air balloon up to Anbu's head to deliver the medication. Oh. Don't you love the detail on that? I mean, oh my gosh. That's such a thing, you know. There's this, yeah, it's a hot air balloon. With the launch platform. That means Anbu can get pets on the snoot. Anbu can, in fact, get pets. Haven't tried that yet. We are about to pick up these nomads, and I want to wait until we get them, and then we can try petting Anbu. It is day 110. We should try petting Anbu. You encountered a group of nomads. Looking for a new home. Some are poisoned and will die soon. Will you let them join your village? Absolutely, we are picking them up. We are not leaving anybody out here. Commit. Two healthy people, three poisoned people, except we have a doctor for this very reason. Lisbeth here is in motion, and we have back to the village doctor, and our second person, Samuel, who is moving to the village doctor, badly poisoned. This person will be a new village doctor if they get to the village doctor in time. Let us wait and see what happens. We did advertise for new people. We are getting new people. That one is poisoned. That one is cured. Right? Rainer? Yeah. Okay. The doctor just got to that person. This one here. And we've got a very busy doctor. My dog is not handling fireworks well at all. I think it's the lack of opposable thumbs. It'd be hard to aim the Roman candles. She's never strike. Yeah, we had some minor issues. We have a heavy blanket that we put over the Boykin Spaniel, which takes care of a lot. Anbu is bloody exhausted, and we really need get Anbu out of this mess here. I'm going, and that goes to food and then to a polar. This goes, we need to make a decision. Do we go to desert or do we go to polar? We go south, let's get Anbu food. Fine, we'll go the Anbu food direction. Whew, we only had a few seconds left. Alrighty. Choose our next research. Okay, yeah, we need to have the Anbu constipator. We have a laxative already. Do we have crops that we can grow in polar? More or less. We have cold-tolerant crops. We don't have cold-weather crops. But then this is a thing here. We will be crossing through this polar biome, and we will move to another biome afterwards, as we've moved to other biomes already. And we just switch crops as necessary along the way. Our toxin level is coming down here. Looks a little maybe... be nice. Alright, we need to get a scavenger party out. Oh, gotta get them out to there as well. That won't be a problem. Moment, this is gonna be a short run here to the forest. Now, our research up here. Let me see if I can reactivate that. They're advertising for a person, or don't have the person to send them, but, you know, that's life. Here's our, by the way, here's our iron furnace. They're chugging along. We've got a nice amount of supply of iron. No ore at the moment. We have all sorts of other things going on. Warehouse here with all sorts of stuff. Massive quantities of wood. Carpenter, stone cutter, glass blower, all sorts of things going on nowadays. I think I commissioned the survival monument. Yes, I did. It's up here. It just hasn't received any of its materials yet. People have been busy with other things. Anbu is about to sack out. Anbu yawned. Anbu is about to sack out, and we are still in the toxic area. Not a good thing to deal with it. Scavenging party returned. Brought back mushroom, but they are poisoned. This was expected. I sent them to a poison forest. They always come back poisoned. One would think that eventually the scavenger team would develop some sort of protective gear. Something that, you know, we couldn't mass produce for everybody, but uh-oh. Well, bad news is Anbu has sacked out in a high toxicity zone. The good news is there's no spore cloud bearing down on us. Send some party to the settlement. This one may get complicated. This is an active settlement. We may end up trading with them. We may end up taking on people. Don't know. It's an oasis where we can get water. We are not going that way. We are going this way to this other zone. Anbu is slowly regaining hunger, but we're going to leave that alone. What we need to do, again, is wait for this to drop to the like 60s, maybe upper 50s, and then wake Anbu up. See if we can get Anbu to a safer area and then let Anbu sleep again. We may be able to let Anbu sleep in the pink zone. We'll have to wait and see what the ground toxicity level is. Because the ground, Anbu is down, we are taking some issues of our own here. We got 16 bread. Plenty of bread made. The scavenger tower is just loaded with stuff. We have, waiting a decision, settlers. Absolutely, we will pick them up. Commit. 3 healthy and 2 hungry. We can feed them. Okay. We are going to do a couple things. I'm going to look here and here. I'm going to put one more person on that farm. I'm going to... These are carriers are maxed out. General workers, I'm going to pick up 1. Windmill, we're going to pick up 1. And then we're going to see where we are in terms of... We've got 1 unemployed right now. Okay, let's see. Let's get a second person at the bakery. Now, we also need to build our first cottage. And we are going to max prioritize it because we have plenty of housing still. We're only at 57 and we have 72 beds available. But I am concerned here. I also want to start knocking down some of these huts and replacing them with cottages. Cottage takes the space of a hut and a half and holds 4 villagers and improves it holds the same number of people as a hut. This is hut is 6 people. Cottage is 4, but improves productivity of the inhabitants. So it's actually less in terms of bed space, but okay. Start building cottages outward from there. Anbu is at 59%. All right, Anbu, I'm sorry. Yeah. We gotta get you moving. I'm sorry. But your poison level is up to 26%, which means I'm now going to have to do another antidote. Okay. Let's go here. I'm going to go zoom in on the Anbu doctor here a bit, because I want to see how this goes. Let us flip back to Anbu level, click here and go antidote, and then click back over to here. Oh my gosh, look at that. Look at that. It's already up. Okay, we're coming back. Fantastic. Look at that. Look at that. Thank you, Wing Princess Alice. Appreciate the gunnery skills there. Alright, so Anbu is cured a bit. Anbu is about to find some Munchie. This place contains some fresh food for Anbu. Let us see if Anbu is going to decide to munch it, or if we need to suggest. Anbu isn't hungry enough to stop and munch. This is a toxic zone. This is not a good place to stop for a bite. If Anbu's not hungry enough to stop, I'm not going to suggest to Anbu that it would be a good idea. Because it's not a good idea. Oh, that's not the damn spore cloud. Oh, I hate it already. Maybe it's moving away from me. Maybe. I hope. Oh, go away, spore cloud. Go. Don't like you. We're scavenging. Of course, let's see how we're doing here. We got, no idols. Everybody employed. That's not hard. I need a new general purpose hut. A new work hut. It's a new worker post. Here is what it's called. Lap. There. That worker post is going to be carriers, because we need more carriers. We have maxed out on carriers, and we just don't have enough people to get stuff schlepped around. Get a more rapid schleppment. We are going to be crossing here into the next biome very shortly. We'll see it up here. Also see it here. We're going to be getting out of this grossness. Just watch this for a minute. Oh, bugger. I was on mute that whole time. Is your mic supposed to be in use? Your voice went silent. Yeah, I must have leaned on the button. I'm sorry. Okay, we are now dealing with a medium toxicity level because of the ground, but it's better than it was? Whew. I like the sound Anbu makes when they lay down, yummy too. Yeah, it's... the detail on the sound production and on the art and so forth and animation, it's just really... this is a lovingly produced game. It kinda needs to be, because it works it works best by making you getting you to care about Anbu. And from Anbu to oh, we have all left our mic unmute for long periods before. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's not just you that does that, Willow. Oh gosh, I make my living as a major incident manager, which is a sort of IT fire captain. I get brought in when there's a big outage to kind of direct the efforts and maintain communications, that sort of thing. And yeah, having to tell somebody, hey dude, are you talking to mute? That happens on almost every call, that there's always somebody who's... yeah. We were working on... yeah, we theoretically were working on a scout tower, but it's kind of deprioritized right now. We've got more important things. The scout tower, when done, will expand the visible radius here. We can only build... we can build as many as we want, but we only get benefit from the first one. They do not stack. We have an old Minecraft stream where I'm muted 70% through. I made a lot of jokes about Skeletor that just didn't make it to stream, which was a shame. I think my record was like 4 or 5 Overwatch matches in a row. Oh, good grief. Yeah. Being on mute when you didn't mean to be is just everybody does that. I deal with it daily in my professional life. That is a ruined settlement. Mines. That's a we've got a shrine over there. We've got an embarrassment of riches here. I'm kind of glad Anbu has decided to sleep, and I'm going to let Anbu sleep this time because we're in an area that is not safe, but safer. However that emoji is meant to be pronounced. Yeah. Is that even? That doesn't even tell me what it... silly thing, I thought I could mouse over it. Alright, I actually want to go to that mine first. Day 115. By the way, we didn't look closely at it, but it's right next to the trebuchet. That's the horn we use to give commands to Anbu, which they really shouldn't be called commands. I mean, they're really more like suggestions, given the size of Anbu. The power dynamic is pretty obvious. We can suggest. The trebuchet is what we use to fire the Scooby Snacks. We saw that earlier in a I will probably be firing one off in the near future, as Anbu is at 27% hunger, and there is no Anbu Chow anywhere along our path for a while. Excuse me. Let's see. Working on the greenery. Right now, well, we got four people poisoned. That just got a little better. Nope. And one person just picked up. Great. Our doctors are very busy. Okay, we got iron ore. Let's go for this iron ore. Go to here and find our village doctor and add a person. There's not actually a person to add, so that's going to put the flag up. And the next time somebody joins our village, the doctor will get priority on them. There is a certain amount of necessity of assigning people to work. I would imagine there is some sort of that in reality there would be migration between the various trades later on, but there are times when, you know, you take somebody on board and you're like, oh thanks, we desperately need hands in the bakery. Whatever you've done before, you're gonna bake bread for a little while. We can move you somewhere else once we have somebody else making food. That sort of thing is going to happen. Our mycologist should also get another person at some point, and I would really like to give the Anbu kitchen another person, but they've been making some things here. We don't have I'm going to switch this over to making the Anbu constipator for a little while. I need to look at the map. Send out to the shrine. Get bloody thunderstorm, worry worry. Got a few minutes before I have to worry too much about it. Go to the theater here, and we have 8 Scooby Snacks and a full load of laxatives. We need the constipators loaded, and we need more Scooby Snacks made. So, we have flipped the Anbu kitchen over from making laxatives to constipators. And from there, it's mushrooms and stone. Well, that makes sense. In an earlier session, Anbu found a patch of rocks that looked quite a bit like Anbu food. And so Anbu ate the rocks. I tried giving Anbu a command to move on, but trust level was not great at that point, and Anbu ignored it and ate the rocks anyway. Fortunately, I already had the laxative in process. You know, I already had it in, had researched it and was starting to make it. I just had to hope I could get one made quick enough. Anbu wanted a crunchy snack. Yeah, there was an old Saturday Night Live commercial for Quarry Natural cereal. Quarry, it's better because it's mined. And one of the jokes, people are eating the cereal and making a terrific amount of grinding noises, and the kid at the table says something, and Mom says, "What?" And the kid says it louder, and Mom says, "What?" And the kid finally shouts, "I like Quarry because it's crunchy." materials that we need delivered here. A lot of stuff going on. The carriers are just darned busy. Did we get our new hut built here? No, that's the glass blower. Here's our worker post, which is not built yet. Let us go out here, and this is... They're turning out stone. Again, carriers. We don't have enough carriers. Scavenging party came back with a point of knowledge. Let us send them to the ruined settlement and go. There is a poison forest here and spore cloud. Spore cloud and a strong thunderstorm. You know, there's a point where it's no longer a challenge, and it's just like the game saying, fuck you. We're at 19%, 30% hunger. We are definitely going to need to feed Anbu a Scooby when Anbu awakens. So if you haven't seen the animation for that, you're gonna... I need to get dirt road built out to the quarry and out to... Also, you need to get a bunch of stone harvested. Good grief. Look at all this. Go pop. Have not been paying attention to the... We'll get this sorted here. But that's not a spine. I can pop. Oh. That marks all those stone for harvest. It wants me to do the blood extractor. I do not like this. Reduces its health and trust in you. There is a reason why you need Anbu blood, but I am nervous about it. I'm going to research the food stand. Commit. That'll allow me to put, so that, you know, people don't have to go to the pantry and kitchen to get food. I can put a food stand, like, out here. Over here, by the berry gatherer, whatever. The sawmill, by the way, is mining the giant stump for wood. Incidentally, I did get an achievement last session. There's a achievement called Very Good. I'm having strawberry shortcake flashbacks. I'm sorry. It has to do with the efficiency of the berry gatherer. If you get your berry gatherer workstation up to a certain efficiency, you get the Chivo. It just sort of happened. It went, oh. Good morning, Anbu. I brought breakfast. Brought back 17 bread. Cool. We're gonna wait until we do the feeding thing before I go zooming out to the map level. Music in this biome reminds me of a piece by Kitaro from one of the Silk Road albums. Think it was the first one, I'm not sure. Scooby snack away! Worry. That's going to be a problem if we go that direction. There we go. There's where it hits us. This hits us here. Get another doctor, we should get another herbalist. Crunch, Anbu. Yep. Oh, look at that. Two full water tanks, one almost full, and one working on it. Good. We will have plenty of water stashed the next time we hit a desert biome. Decisions. This wavering edge is maddening. Wanting to see just a little further. Which is why we are supposedly building a scout tower, but this needs to happen first, and for some reason just isn't happening at all, and I don't know why. Not sure where the materials are all going. Always a possibility. Well, our stonecutter could use a person. Our carpenter could use a person. Go on and put the flag up for people at those places. Hopefully it'll all fill in the order we put the flag up. Think it does. I really ought to check the documentation on that. That storm moves way faster than we do. I'm thinking my best bet is if we get too close, get into it, is to tell Anbu to run. No bother. Now, is that fireworks or is that gunfire? That's a question in this neighborhood. Send party to the large quarry. Watch the thunderstorm. If the thunderstorm goes out that way and starts coming back and we're in the rectangle, I'm definitely telling Anbu to run. See how things go. Anbu's poison level is only 16%, hunger level is 15%, sleepiness is 15%, health is 100%, we're doing really well. Heart rate, 3 beats per minute. There is a Chivo for getting Anbu's heart rate up to a certain BPM, and I don't remember what it is. I think it's like 6. Okay. Here's the nervous part. As late at night as it is, and we only heard those few boom, bump, bump, bump noises, I'm willing to bet that was Sterling letting off a few rounds, possibly at a varmint, possibly just to let me know that he still has ammo. Bang! There's another one! Someday maybe I will learn to do my own moderation while I'm playing a game. Today is not that day. Uh-oh. Here it comes. Here we are. I don't want to tell Anbu to run unless I have to, but it's looking more and more like it. Which way is that one going? It's going that way. We are going to go that way. We'll deal with the spore cloud rather than the strong thunderstorm. The strong thunderstorm is hitting for us. Okay, that's fireworks. Kind of late on us for it, but all right, come on, get out of there, get out of there, get out of there. You can do this. Come on, come on, Anbu, come on, come on. We're almost clear, and we're clear. Walk. Whew. Okay. Dodged that one. Real down to the wire hours, yeah. Problem is, this is Nashville. Tennessee is known as a fireworks producing state. And I am in a white supremacist enclave within Nashville, which is the capital of a right-wing state. It's the... Yeah, there's a lot of ordnance floating around. Let's just leave it at that. There's a settlement out there. I'm excited. And since we're going this way, I'm more need to go on and hit it next, because we're going to lose the ability to in just a very short time. By dodging this thunderstorm, that's a poison for us. That's just a spore cloud. It's not us. That's the one we dodged. This is the one we've avoided entirely. Seven iron ore. Brilliant. Okay, we have loaded up. No, open the research tree. Just open the research tree. Show me what I have not done. Stone Road. I want Stone Road. Quit telling me I need that damn blood extractor. I'll research it at some point, but not right now. Mori Oski. What's wrong with you? Alright. Okay. Still no materials being delivered. It's wanting wood plank, which is made at the carpenter. There's plank. Made at the stone slab is here. Here's our iron. And oh, I hit a glass blower. I just don't remember where. Here, glass. It's glass. Materials are there, just we don't have... I'm thinking we don't have carriers. That we're just too damn busy otherwise. Can't get anything... Can't get the stuff delivered. Maybe picking up from all the stuff that I've been harvesting. I did do a big surge of harvesting, and that would occupy the carriers pretty heavily. Food stand researched. I want to build a food stand. Actually, I want to build a couple of food stands. Food stand. We'll put one here. And then I'm going to put one there. Not a pleasant location, but you know, people get to work there. That is the dung collector and the compost heap that turns Anbu's waste into biogas, which is then sent over to the decontaminators to power. Oh, bugger. Poisonous air. Increased toxicity. Here comes the spore cloud. This is likely to be a bad one. Let us run on Boo. See if we can get through here faster. Getting to prioritize. No, this one. Good. They're already harvesters. That should be my general workers. Okay. Issue has passed. Walk. Slow Anbu down. Anbu's way tired now. He ran Anbu for a while there. it's already tagged. It's tagged. This is not tagged. Hey, just let him have a minute here. No party available. Where are we? Where is my... Awaiting decision. Settlers, pick them up. Absolutely. Four people. And every one of them is immediately employed because we have flags up. There's a decontaminator working. And here is a harvester taking out a poison plant. Let's follow these two decontaminators and see what they do. A couple of researchers. Maybe heading for the pantry. Who knows? Get all these poison plants cleared off, then I can put my work party here from harvesters back to general workers. They were still sent to harvest from the last... Oh, what do we got here? Cold snap. Whoop-de-shit. I can worry about a cold snap. That's just not even a thing. Okay, we want to hit this poison, and well, want to hit this forest before we lose sight of it. Okay. How are we doing here? Oh, hey, there we go. Cold snap has hit. We're just gonna, pardon the pun, we're just gonna have to weather it and weather it. We have harvesters also at work here. So we're getting this done. It's just the cleanup after a spore cloud takes time. Right now, our crop production is going to be for shit. It's too cold for the wheat. The beets are surviving. We don't have anything that we can grow in this kind of weather yet. Next time I need to bring up the research. Got breaks in my road here. Those will need to be closed up at some point. Kinda want the stone road. Not making any progress on it right now. Harvester working up there on that plant. Yes, okay. Some of these breaks in the road fixed. and waiting for Stone Road isn't going to work out. I need to go on and get the road fixed. Okay, you're still in the cold snap. Just deal. Oh, look. That's a sleepy spot. If we could just get Anbu to it. Anbu is so tired right now from the run to get past the storm and the spore cloud that Anbu is going to nap out soon. Anbu is also very hungry. I wonder if we can feed Anbu before Anbu sacks out. Let's hold that. Anbu, and we will feed Anbu when Anbu wakes up. In the meantime, looking over the map, seeing where things are here. Oh! We're going to have to wake Anbu up at some point in the very near future because we have this cold, we're still in the cold snap. Lost woods. Dense fog covers the entrance, making it impossible to see inside. Carefully, your scavengers take a few steps into it when suddenly an uplifting melody resounds from afar. We should follow the melody and see where it leads. This is no ordinary place. We should stay out of it and take what we can from the edge of the forest. Do not follow the fairy music. We are not following the fairy music. These woods have much to offer. The troop heads back with their pockets full of resources. 24 wood. Good enough. Let us just work our way around a little bit. Still hearing some pop, pop, pop outside. I'm going to wait until I'm no longer hearing noises outside before I sign off. Now, of course, I'm expecting the really massive barrage to be not tomorrow night, but Tuesday night. But that's another thing entirely. Let's see what happens there. Okay. I'm going to flip these folks here back to being general workers. ...79%. Come on, Anbu. We need to get out of here, but can't wake you up yet. Unfortunately, we're just at the edge of it when Anbu. The music leads to a group of fairies. They want your names. Do you give them? Now you have no name. In Earthdawn, that's instantly fatal. Your name is the key to your pattern. Take out your name and it's like taking the keystone out of an arch. Your true pattern collapses and depatterning is messy. Oh. Fuck yeah, those chumps can have my dead name, my current legal name, and the 15 aliases we used in high school. Well, I mean, yeah, there are some names that maybe you don't want. I'm always nervous about giving anything to the fairies for any reason. I mean, justifiably. 71%. A little bit more, a little longer. We can tolerate the freezing. It's just kind of posing with our crop capability here. Messing with our wheat. We'll figure it out later. We are finally, there we go, by flipping them over from harvesters to general workers so that they harvest or carry or whatever. Now we're finally, there we go, it was a labor allocation issue. Okay, we are at 63, oh, we have a decision. Sounds from deep below. Before even taking a step into the mine, splatters on the walls and shouting from within imply that a tragic incident has taken place. There might be people in need. Let's hurry up and check the situation. Don't be hasty. Let's hide behind a rock and wait. We'll sneak in when it's safer. No way this will end well. Let's return. Better safe than sorry, as the saying goes. I'm going to hide and behind a rock and wait. Take the cautious approach. When your scavengers enter the mine, its interior resembles a battlefield. The only thing they can hear is what sounds like snoring from deep within. Oh dear. They grab a few resources and escape before whatever caused this returns or awakens. 23 iron ore, that's a good amount. I'll take it. I got my scavengers back unharmed. Got 23 iron ore, I'm good with that. Let's send them to this mine. Anbu is at 63%. I am sorry, Anbu, but I must awaken you. They get back with 5 iron ore real fast from that one. The person who worked the drive-thru at the coffee place we used to ask, can I have your name? And we would respond with something like, you can write name on the cup if you must. We wonder if they got it. Yeah, you didn't give them the name. Yeah. Yeah, some people will get it and some won't. Little patchy biome. That's a new thing. Okay, we're leaving that, and I want to try and head to that. First, though, we need to send them to the quarry. We have a sleepy spot. Sleepy spot would be a lovely thing to have. Given that we are medium, yeah. Not thrilled with that. Housing, 61 of 76. We need to build more housing. Let us move over here. We do have our cottage built. I'm going to build another cottage. And another cottage. That'll give me 8 more beds. And quality of life improvements for the people using them. I'm going to try and stay well ahead in terms of housing. Our monument is starting, is finally getting its materials. Once we got our labor allocation issue resolved. So many resources, so little time. Day 123. Wow. We've made it to 123 days. We have a population of 61 now. That's getting pretty sizable. Brought back 12 stone. Yippee-yay. Send them there. Okay, looks like they're hauling the stone slab next, and maybe they'll work on iron or wood plank after that. Don't know yet. We'll see. It's happening. It's just taking time. Everything in this game takes time. You have to be somewhat patient and still be able to respond to crises. We should feed Anbu. Is exhausted, is tired and hungry, and we can at least do something about one of those. We have 7. Fire it off. Okay, that will increase Anbu's trust and help Anbu feel better at the same time. I think we should go south. Anbu accepts the command. Okay, we're gonna go south and head for the sleepy spot. We'll see if we get there. Before Anbu decides that Anbu must sleep. Well, before Anbu sleeps. It's not so much a decision as Anbu is just too tired to keep going and lies down wherever Anbu happens to be. Is Star Ocean, let's see, off topic, but gotta tell people, Star Ocean 2 is finally getting the full remake treatment. I never played Star Ocean, but my kids were huge into it. Is Star Ocean the one with Edge Maverick? That's Star Ocean 4. I have no idea. Like I said, my kids were huge into it. Two is the really good one. Three is the one where the final act just doesn't exist for some reason. That seems unfortunate. We're at 79%. I don't think we're going to make it to the sleepy spot. We're going to, yep. We're going to have a nap, another nap before we get there. It'll be a short one. Once I'm boosted down to 60 again, I'll... Uh-oh. Strong thunderstorm. It does not appear to be hitting across here. I don't see a dotted line. There's the rectangle for it. We dodged a thunderstorm by going to the sleepy spot. Hurrah! And a spore cloud. Oh, good decision, finally! Good directional decision, finally. We are ducking out on a spore cloud and a thunderstorm. And going to a snoozy spot. This makes me very, very happy. I am running long, yes. I am going to run to the top of the hour. I want to put in some longer sessions on this and see where it goes, partly because I have Mask of the Rose queued up for the next game, and I am so excited about it. Okay, 15 stone. We're turning that direction. Let's go hit that forest. Or we lose the ability to reach that forest. Anbu is at 85%. Ooh. Yeah. Rest a bit, Ronbu. We'll get you up in a few minutes. Star Ocean 1 has a character named Roddick and a character named Ronix, and I guarantee you there is a pun in there that does not translate to English. Be fun to throw stuff like that in. How is this coming along? Oh, we're getting the wood planks. We've already got the iron, almost all of it. Wow, getting major progress here. We need one more iron and some more wood, and I know we've got the wood. It's just a matter of getting it carried. It is a strange series. Sounds like it. Okay, we now have constipators. We have a full load of laxatives. We are going to go make food. Let us go to the Anbu kitchen and flip it over to making Anbu food. There we go. We have medications in stock now. Start making Scooby snacks again. ~75%. Toxicity is medium. We may get a person or two poisoned. But our productivity is 132%, which is higher than it's been before. 129 was the highest I'd seen it before. Food quality is contributing, food variety, housing quality could be a lot better. The cottages are going to help with that, but oh, here comes our last wood planks. It is now a construction site, and now we wait for builders. Okay, that general worker just became a builder. Fantastic. Here's a second builder, and Yes, it's taking a lot of labor. This is a very big deal. I like the low frame animations up close. They look like the old forgotten cartoons we used to get on VHS from the drugstore. Oh, the animations just are yeah. We're about time to wake. Anbu up, but I want to see this happen. Anbu can sleep in a bit, yes. Well done. I hope this will inspire our people for generations never to give up, to pull through even when the odds seem overwhelming. And most importantly, I hope it reminds them of the value of cooperation, without which survival would have been close to impossible. They are being a little heavy-handed with the lesson, but sometimes you have to be. With this, I think I can finally retire. You have overcome many obstacles, and no matter what else we may yet encounter, I am certain that you will lead us toward a prosperous future. It has been a pleasure to go on this journey with you, and I hope we can go on another one soon, throughout the early access of the Wandering Village and beyond. Thank you for playing this early access version of the Wandering Village. Check out our roadmap to see what we have planned for the game's future, and please make sure to join us over on Discord so we can improve the Wandering Village together. We actually don't want to get into the roadmap because the developers have asked not to stream any of the stuff on it. Totally understandable. They want to be the ones to make the announcements. Horn walk. Anbu is at 52%. Not well rested, but Anbu will have a chance to get sleep here, which we've already queued Anbu up for. Send the party to the mine. Anbu walks. Anbu is moving. Okay. We are going to do one other thing. We're going to pet Anbu. We're launching the doctor. I think your prediction was correct. We are actually going to boop Anbu on the snoot. Or pat on the top of the head, maybe? Oh my god. Anbu is loved and cherished. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was a thing. And we have gotten the Petting Zoo achievement. We have successfully petted Anbu, and we got the Petting Zoo achievement. Anbu has turned southward, is heading for rest. Scavenging a food stand has been constructed. So we have a food stand out here. Needs a person to operate it. Once there's a person, we can get food out here. Made from Anbu blood? Ew. No. Grilled tomato. Okay. Brought back 7 iron ore. Let's see. Let's pop them off to the poison forest. Shall we? No, I'm going to send them to the quarry. I want metal more than I want mushrooms and poisoned people. What do we got here? Tasty looking stones. Oh, bugger. We have seen that before. This is why we have a full stock of laxatives. Lordy, lordy. Okay. Things happening, things going on. The scout tower is now getting materials. It'll be built at some point in the not too distant future. We've picked up an achievement for petting Anbu. We've got the statue built, the monument, which I don't know what all it does for us mechanically, but it certainly gave us a big landmark in the game. Let us see if Anbu is at 64%. Anbu is likely... Oh! Fresh air, free from any toxins. Anbu is likely to... Yes. Come to a halt. Anbu... has found a snoozy spot. A safe, good-smelling snoozy spot. Love Rock, enjoy Rock. Yeah, unfortunately Rock does not love you. I am not as accustomed to spicy food as I used to be, which bothers me. I need to get back in the habit of seasoning my food a bit more. But living off of microwave crap. But, yeah, I really loved the camarones chipotle that I had at Mestizo's the other day, but they didn't love me so much. 14 stone. We'll go to the mine. See if we can get some iron ore. That said, I'm still going to go back for the camarones con mojo y ajo. Nashville, one of those things people don't expect. Nashville, Tennessee has 5-star Mexican cuisine. We have Oaxacan restaurants, we have Jaliscan places, we have just about anything. There's a place near us, Rancho Cantina, that's a Oaxacan place. I had the tlirismares there for my birthday dinner. A shrimp 3 different ways. It was amazing. But then going out to Mestizo's, which is, this is not expensive. Mestizo's Yes, it's no more expensive than any storefront restaurant. I mean, it was in a little minor, a little bitty strip mall type storefront next to a laundromat. I'm doing like 5-star shrimp in a chipotle cream sauce with grilled bell peppers and onions, and it was so good, but yeah. I had a little trouble with it. I'm old, I'm out of practice. Used to, the worker post has been constructed. I am excited. Scout tower has been constructed, and we got that's a red-winged hawk, I think, that we get the call. This one, I'm going to set it to carriers and let it have two people. Scout tower, we're going to hear that every time we click it, aren't we? Oh, that's going to get annoying. Whoop. Anbu is up. Anbu is down to a zero sleepiness. Fantastic. And we brought breakfast. Seven iron ore. Yes, that's what we're talking about. Oh, there it went. It has been a thing here, hasn't it? We are putting up new housing, we've taken on new people, we've headed Anbu finally. We've got let's go for forest there. What the heck, we can always use wood. Research is going very slowly. Food stand is advertising for a person. Research building. Well, I mean, let's go on and click that up. Start. I want to see what I can do about getting to, like, full compliments on some of these functions here. You know, we can actually start thinking about fully staffing. That would be an amazing thing. fully staffed. We've been surviving on skeleton crews for so long. Cottage constructed. Hurrah. And three cottages constructed. We are starting to see maybe an improvement in housing quality. A 1% improvement. It's not great, but I'll take it. We got 84 housing. I actually want to cancel the hut. And instead, disassemble that hut and disassemble this hut, and we'll replace them with a cottage. Let's start working on that. It's going to take some time. We're going to have to build more cottage, obviously. Got a bit of dirt road here that needs to be built. Yeah. Oh, Anbu. We're going to deal with the rocks next time. I would like to point out that, well, pretty much I think everybody here is part of the Truck Community Streamers, a group that I'm proud to be part of. And find our schedule at this URL. There's somebody streaming pretty much every night. We've got a very full schedule. I'd like to keep it that way. I'd also like to point out that I do a historical fiction piece called Bread Spotting, which you can find. Mention the truck community and boom, lots of trucks. And you can find my historical fiction at that Patreon. First scene is free. As it says in the slug on the screen, trans rights are human rights. Black lives matter and indigenous lives matter, and land back is a thing, and decolonization is not a theory, it is a practice. We need to be thinking about these things, and we need to be thinking about the fact that if we don't learn to live in some sort of symbiosis, oh bother, Anbu, don't eat the rocks. There just doesn't seem to be a way to tell Anbu not to eat the rocks. If we don't learn to live in some sort of symbiosis with the land we're on, we're going to be in just as much trouble as these people living aboard Anbu, who has just eaten a rock and is now constipated. This is going to be a little bit of a thing, and we will deal with that in just a minute here. We'll fire that off, and we'll be dealing with that next session. So we are going to leave Anbu being treated with what Anbu thought was a Scooby and is not actually a Scooby. And it's going to be a thing. Fortunately, we don't have graphics, but this is where we will leave off and leave you with the thoughts of cooperation being key to survival. It is a thing. It is such a thing. Until next week, safe journeys, space fans.